Okay, get rid of that. Yes, I am late, Isaac. Purely because I don't know how to do things correctly. That is pretty much it. All right, see if we get any more people coming in before we start this. Darren, hello. Federico, imagine the day they are going to release the new tire model and new graphics. I don't know. Is that something that... Well, Conan and I can talk about that in a minute, if he knows anything about that.
I know enough to be depressed.
Oh. Fair. Fair. We're all suffering from that. Star Fox says, great topic. Can't wait. All right. So let me go here and game capture, please. Does not, thank you, there we go. Although that looks odd. And, okay. On stream, that looks weird. I wonder if it's because...
What part looks weird?
Oh, the graphics on straight. Oh no, it's just the monitor. Oh, I got a crappy monitor over there apparently.
Okay. It does look normal.
Yeah. My second monitor must be very special. Look, it was budget. All right.
Yeah. I've got one that like, cause I like to have them at an angle, like around me.
Yes.
And same. I've got one that if you set it at an angle, it just turns into blackness. Like it's like you turn the saturation way down on everything. It's classy.
Yeah, this one, I think the saturation's too high, and I can't seem to get it to function properly. Mm. All right. Rolanzo, hello. Darren, is there a Porsche in this? Not officially?
Yeah, how do you phrase that? There's a legally distinct Porsche in it.
Right. All right, so we'll get going. This is Live for Speed. Cone, did you want to go by Cone Dodger? Yes? No?
Just Cone is good.
Cone. Okay. So, Cone does Twitch streams, YouTube stuff, and have you been doing this longer than me, or about as long, or what?
Well, interesting.
I started in 2013.
Live for Speed is the first series I ever did on YouTube,
and that okay.
was late 2012.
Ah, so Cone's been doing this longer than I have. But Ash, hello.
We were pretty much at the same time, if you will.
Nice. I didn't even know that. I think I found you a little later.
Yeah, I think I kind of got more into the eye of the sim racing scene because I was one of the first, I feel, that did like an actual iRacing Let's Play.
Mm-hmm.
That was unique back in the day. And I don't know. That's kind of the extremes of where I got with sim racing stuff. Did a lot with Assetto Corsa on YouTube, man.
Yes.
That's probably the most, I don't know. That's the greatest quantity of stuff that I ever did. But Live for Speed is where it started.
Nice.
And Live for Speed is kind of where, I want to say it's where I started with sim racing, but obviously, you know, it was before that. But is everything before that technically sim racing, and was I even old enough to recognize it? Like I played GPL, I played NASCAR,
right.
You know, 2, 3, 4, all of those, but it's different.
So, and you've been doing this a lot longer than me as far as just PC sim racing, quote unquote, in general, because I didn't get into it until about 20. I tried in 2013 and hated it. So I stepped away for about 2 years and then came back in 2015. And really tried to figure it out because it bothered me that all this cool stuff, what I perceived to be cool stuff, was on the PC, and I couldn't get the hang of it. So, this is a fresh, basically, experience for me. I've had a whole of probably 90 minutes in Live for Speed. That was setting things up. This was probably about 2-3 years ago. I think we did some of the license tests. Or not tests, but the whatever they are.
Yeah, it's very similar to the Gran Turismo style, where you like go through all the different little steps, the little baby steps of driving.
Yeah, and I think we made a little ways through that, and that was about it. So this would be my, would you say, first proper introduction to Live for Speed. We're on our own little private server here. We've picked the XR GT Turbo, and what do you want to do? What you want to make some laps, and you can kind of tell me what to give me a backstory or a history lesson?
Yeah, let's do some laps. I think this is probably the most Live for Speed combo. This is like one of the original cars. This is the original track. Tons of people only ever experienced Live for Speed through the demo. And the demo is literally the game. Like, it is just actual in-game content. It just limits what you can, you know, get to.
Fair enough.
I do love that it tells me which way to go out of the pits. We need more of that.
Please go this way. Well, you know, every once in a while you get the guy that's pointing the wrong direction.
Oh, yeah.
And like R-Factor, that's always fun.
So, yeah, this game is... it's actually ancient, and I don't know. Do you know exactly the era in which this came out?
Well, I did look. I did cheat. I looked it up because I wanted to know. I know I'm a big cheater.
So it's pretty nuts to think that this game, pretty much in its entirety, is from 2002. Like, the basis of this is 20 years old. And I know some would say, "Yeah, it looks like an old game." Sure. But it looks so much different than it did then.
So this was pretty much... so, for everybody, this is long before iRacing. This is before a lot of even semi-current things. Not even necessarily just current things. Just things that we're familiar with. Because what? R-Factor was... school me here. Is 05?
Yeah, I think that's... because R-Factor is born from Sports Car GT, right?
Yes.
So I think that was that era, that changeover. Sports Car GT was kind of a competitor to this, if you will, along with NetCar, if anybody remembers NetCar.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, my pedal squeaking. It's awesome.
I didn't think I would hear it, but I do hear it.
Okay, I'm going to have to. That's going to drive me nuts.
Break out the WD-40.
Yeah, I'm going to have to do it real quick.
Squeak, squeak.
That's gonna
in my head,
bananas.
You've got a can like next to the desk that you can just... you got it in a hole.
I literally do actually have it down by the pedals. Hold on, everybody. I need a pit stop.
We just missed the pits, though.
Well, by the magic of Sims, now I'm sitting there. Federico says... What new Sims can learn is simplicity out of this sim. What I like the most is that almost completely fictional, apart from some cars, the sound engine is also interesting as a concept.
I can agree with a lot of that.
Yeah.
I think the simplicity of it definitely makes it approachable to some degrees. The audio seems pretty desynced.
Hold on.
He's out of here. He ain't gone.
Yep. I got things to do.
He's been raptured.
I'll fix it in just a sec. I think I finally figured out what it is that screws up my sync. I believe it's Discord.
Oh.
Let me restart, and then we should be good. Okay. It begins. All right, hold on. Be back in just a second. Cone, you're not going anywhere, though. Hey, we're back. Okay. Yeah. I don't know. Hopefully that fixed it. Yeah, there's something that happens, and it seems... I've been racking my brain trying to figure it out, but it seems to be that Discord... something slowly desyncs it. It'll start out right, and then it'll just slowly desync. So hopefully this stays. All right. That's when... Oh, you got things. Okay, go for it. Where am I at? Okay. Oh. Oh. Oh, snap. Look at that. Huh. Oh, God damn it, Discord. Sorry. Christ on a crutch. Okay. You know. Try it again. There we go. Hello? There you are. Jeez. Restarted it. It decided to kill the audio for you. All right. Start again. Sorry.
So yeah, you're looking at the force view, which is showing all the live, basically, outputs of the suspension, if you will. So when you hit drop, it's giving the car a little bit of load, and you can see, you know, what kind of changes are happening. So if you were to change the suspension, if you're going to soften the springs, whatever, you can kind of get a little bird's eye view of what's going on there. But even cooler than that, and literally how I learned how to set up race cars.
Oh.
On the next thing down where it says suspension.
Mm-hmm.
That is a live view of all the suspension geometries.
Oh, that's fancy.
So, yeah, you can not only can you see what are all those changes doing,
right.
You can see kind of just how suspension works, like how the relation of the different arms are affecting it, what the advantages and disadvantages of like a McPherson strut versus double wishbone. Personally, I learned more about suspension from this than anything else in the real world. Because it's just a great visual representation.
Yeah, this is actually way better. I mean, just this in itself, I'm a fairly visual person. So
yeah,
this in itself is a really good representation of like where your how your tires are sitting. This is really cool. I did not know this.
And then if you go on track, which I guess we can do now.
Okay.
You can actually watch that live as well. So if you hit the F key while you're driving.
Okay. Boink.
You become a floating man.
This is sweet.
So yeah, I usually would do it in a replay. So where you,
right.
You would watch this kind of force data, and it's going to show all the different suspension loading and the lateral drift.
This is almost like a debug mode or something. Like yeah. This is reminds me of Assetto Corsa to an extent, but not really, because you could kind of, if you're messing with it, you oh there you go, look at that. You could kind of see what's going on.
And you could
but not to this
start to
extent.
Understand like, hey, why when I'm exiting a turn does the inside wheel start to spin? Well, you can see, oh, that tire is unloading at that point, or you know, if you're fighting some kind of handling thing, you can actually have a visual representation of what's going on there. And I found that to be super helpful because this was pretty early into me working on cars even, so it was kind of how I got a grasp of how all of that would work.
Yeah, look, it tells you like when you can actually feel when it touches the curb. I mean, I'm watching you, but I've also got the right front in my view.
Right.
That's pretty neat. I like seeing the little, I don't know if those are still the colored arrows or what underneath the tires, but I can see the colors happening. Maybe it's telling like when it breaks traction. Whoops.
Yeah, so you'll see whenever you get an overload of, say, lateral grip.
Yeah.
It'll spike to red.
Yeah, okay. That's really interesting.
It is. We'll do it live.
Yes. Okay. So let's ask her. You can answer your, give me your thought here. Why don't modern Sims do this?
I mean, it's all going to be theory, right? But
sure. But, you know, that's what we're here for.
I kind of always was under the assumption that you don't want to lift up the curtain, right?
Okay.
Like, if you show up front what the forces are doing, you're going to see the glaring mistakes. And you see the glaring mistakes in this, too. Like, you can see when things aren't right. Like, there's going to be flaws in a tire model. Every tire model. And I don't know, it feels a little jeopardizing to the accuracy of your sim if you can see where things have shortcomings. Whether it's that or they just don't think it's that important, I don't know. Because to me, it's pretty important. Like, that's a tool, especially for visual learners, that is invaluable to me.
It just helps somebody that's trying to learn. Right, not everybody's going to do this, but those that want to learn,
right,
it is so much better. So one of the things that really confused me when I started sim racing it felt like, it, not so much now, but it did feel like then, everybody had a different way of explaining the same thing. And it was very confusing to me because I learned how to set up a certain way. Like, I call it toe in, toe out. And for me, that means a very specific thing. And I found that other devs... Ooh, a little too deep. other devs would explain it the exact opposite that I learned, or would call something completely different, and without seeing a visual reference, or without them very clearly explaining what they meant, I had to do guesswork. I had to just mess with it and see when I made a change, is that the change that I was expecting to happen? And then, of course, you have things that happen where you expect a change that you've made to make a difference, and then it doesn't. And so it becomes a very difficult way of trying to understand what the sim is giving you. Especially
go ahead. If you have real world knowledge.
Yes.
If you have real world knowledge, it's constantly fighting you.
Ooh. Hello.
And then if you want even more information, honestly, less information, but a little bit easier for your eyes to read. If you un-F.
Un-F, okay.
Un-F yourself.
Heyo.
And if you hit F9, it's going to give you the same kind of live data, but about your tires.
Okay. Da-da-da-da, if I don't crash. F9. Oh, here we go. Ah, okay, so even that, like, we kind of get this, right?
Kind of getting it now. I feel like there was a big lull where we weren't getting that, but I think we've kind of gotten back to it now. So you're getting the top three are going to be your, basically, the bars are the pressure on that part of the tire. Then you've got the temperature below that, and then the color representations, it's going to be the... Basically,
the heating of the tire,
the whole of the tire is the center part.
Uh huh.
And then on the surface of that is how much tread is left, so that will wear away, basically. And then you've also got the section by section temperature. So if you lock up, I guess this car has ABS, so it's probably a little hard to do that. But if you hook a good skid,
wee. Shown's going
you actually start to see those temperatures come up on every part of the tire and how it will
there,
cool
yeah.
down over time.
I did a little flash on the right front, yeah.
How much dirt is on the tire, too, which is cool.
Oh, really?
Yeah, if you go in the dirt, it'll bring up a brown bar on that and show you.
Oh, look at that!
So it's just
how cool is that?
Information that it gives you that I really appreciate, and in a way that I think is pretty easy to read.
Yeah, you can see the ABS kicking in just a little, and you can see the little red pop up in the tire.
Yeah. It's a pretty rudimentary. I assume it's correct to the era too. Like if you've ever driven a 90s car with ABS, it feels like somebody's taking a sledgehammer to the brake pedal.
Yeah, it's just on off. It's
very unpleasant. I always disconnected on a car that I get from that era. I think that's pretty much all I have to explain about the visuals, though. I think that's a lot of the mentality that I really miss in the more modern games.
Isaac's like, do a drift. I
gotta say, this is probably one of the best how to drift simulators, too.
I don't drift a whole lot.
I don't
except if it's on dirt. So, and the force feedback is still.
I drive. Yeah,
yes. Force feedback is still a little heavy for me. And I'm clear down at 15.
I have to go even lower.
Might.
All right, let's.
All right. Pit side.
Pit stuff is all pretty rudimentary. It was kind of stuff that was added later. They actually do full endurance style pits and everything. You can change out drivers and all that stuff, which I think this is one of the first that I remember that you could change out drivers in mid-race, but there's no visual representation or anything like that.
So it says you made a pit stop. Did you hit a button or?
Nope, you just park in a box.
Oh, park in a box.
Park in a box and then get there.
Nice. Well, I like that a lot. That, I had no idea.
Wait, look at my bulleted list here. Pits. I'm a professional.
No, Cone's got notes. All right, let me scroll through some of the chat here.
Yeah.
Here's when I was screwing it up, and we were desynced, and then I forgot your audio. MagnetOS says, sports car GT'd so much, wasn't aware R-Factor was the continuation of that. Yes.
Yeah, I can't remember exactly how that lineage goes, but it's essentially that engine.
Well, yeah, I mean, right, clear up to race room. I mean, I know, and the Automobilista, the first one.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
People are talking about that view that we just used. Yeah, that's really, I like that idea. It just helps if somebody is trying to understand. Oh, race ends? Are we ending? Oh, okay, we're changing cars?
Yeah, it's going to kick you back to here.
All right.
We're changing everything now.
Sweet. Matt says, hey, Matt, you need the LFS Tweaker app. Hours of fun just with that. Federico, and if you use the car editor, you can see the modification of suspension geometry live. Sick. Nobody likes being exposed. Flat spots too, yep. Somebody said, will we playing Billy's favorite game? How easy is a custom server setup? I like buttons.
Personally, it's easy because you do it within the game. You don't have to do any kind of dedicated. You can, but you don't have to. You can literally just set it up in the game, hit go, and it's open.
Let's see. So are we changing cars?
Yep. I'm going to go. Let's go for something that's a little bit more race car, but not too race car.
Okay. So here's all of our options of official.
Official cars, yeah. You want to go front wheel drive or all wheel drive?
I don't care.
Let's go front then. Yeah. XF GTR.
XF GTR. Okay. Yellow. Da-da-da-da. Okay.
This should be a nice, it's a pretty well-mannered car.
Okay.
Overall.
And we're going to go Rockingham, I see.
Which is the newest track they ever did. So,
which is no longer a track.
Yeah, somebody was asking, asking about the future of the game. And, you know, if they're going to release new tire models. They just recently basically started working on the game again after about a 10-year lull.
Mm-hmm.
And they finally released this track, which was, it had to have been a decade ago that they teased it. They had this track, and they got the license for the Volkswagen Scirocco.
Oh.
And were going to be added to the game. Like, they were going to have their first real car and their first real track. I don't know what happened. I don't know if anybody does. Something must have blown up with that, because it never went anywhere.
Huh.
So they just eventually released the track, and the car disappeared, and that's when they introduced the modding stuff.
So, kind of talk about the structure when it was released. I cheated. I was looking a little bit, and it was released in phases. So you have a 1, 2, and a 3. You have the original release, which is 2002.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have the first tier, which was 03.
Yeah, it was, I don't know if I remember the exact years, but yeah, it was the first tier, which was a few cars, like 6 cars and like 3 tracks. And then they would just keep adding content through those, but it took forever. Like, it took years to get to S3. S2 was the most for a long time. All right, this is going to be floppy paddle, yeah. Should have a limiter too. I don't know if you have it selected or not.
Oh no, I don't know. I guess I'll find. Oh nope, that's a message.
No, did it just just
I may have to map one here or figure out which button I mapped
it to.
Probably
fine. I don't think we're gonna be doing competitive pit stops.
There it is. I found it. So this is a sequential?
Yep.
Okay.
First turn sneaks up on you. I don't have as much experience on this track because it is on the newer side.
Oh, I have no idea where I'm going. I'm just following you, so.
A little bit of a loud sucker. Did you get that force feedback down? Because this thing will probably rip your arms off.
This one's actually good.
Oh.
Yeah, this one's actually not as strong as the other car.
So yeah, I did a bit of league racing and stuff like that in this on a more competitive... You're going to get me.
I gotcha.
The servers were kind of the Wild West. They were left to do their own thing, like as far as matchmaking goes. And a lot of them came up with really creative solutions towards that stuff where you would earn points and basically move up through their servers.
Oh, wow.
So it was kind of iRacing before iRacing. And that was fun. I don't know if that stuff still exists, but that's how it was back in the day.
What I do like about this is it feels very intuitive. Like, I'm not struggling to understand what the car is doing. I mean, I'm learning what it's doing, but I kind of talked about this the other day when I did a stream with R-Factor 2, is that I kind of judge how well something is built in Sim depending on how far down the track I'm looking. Because I noticed when I am very uncomfortable with a car, when I feel like it's doing things that I don't expect it to do, I tend to look much closer to the nose of the car.
Right.
And when I get more comfortable, I'll look further ahead. And when I'm comfortable right out of the gate, I will automatically look ahead. And that's what I'm doing with this. I'm not worried so much about... There's a feeling that the car has, as I blow that turn. there's a feeling that the car has that I feel like even if I overstep the limit of the car, I can learn from it and then adjust.
Right.
Which is, for me, that's kind of the whole point of trying to drive fast.
Yeah.
So this feels very intuitive.
I always had a gripe with R-Factor and anything that was ISI-based, that it always felt like I was telling the computer how to drive the car. I was not driving the car. Like, there was a middleman. And things like Live for Speed or NR2K3 iRacing, they felt less middleman. Oh, another one is GTR. I love GTR, but it never felt, yeah, it never felt intuitive to me. Like, it always felt like I had to deal with an interpreter to drive the car.
Okay.
But a lot of that comes down to personal preference, too.
Yeah, I mean, hello. I tend to, I don't drive by force feedback.
Mm-hmm.
So I think people that tend to drive by force feedback definitely look for a very specific way that things are conveyed to them. And for me, I started racing RC cars when I was like 5. Right. So that visual representation has always stuck with me. So I use a mix of, yeah, I like force feedback.
Yeah,
I mean, but I'm not.
It as a tool.
Yeah, I'm using it as informational, not the sole source of how I'm driving. So I can, for me, I can tend to hop between simulators fairly easy and not have too much of a problem unless I feel like it's broken. So like when I first tried iRacing clear back in 2013, I hated it because it felt so disconnected.
Very much so the same.
Most of them felt odd to me. So, I think R-Factor is weird, where R-Factor kind of feels cool, then sometimes it doesn't.
Yeah.
I always liked GTR2, I thought felt pretty good.
That was probably the pinnacle for them, which I think is not a controversial opinion.
Yeah. So, yeah, this just kind of gives me the feeling that I can kind of hop in a car, just like I did when I... So when I first started, went from oval racing, and then I started learning how to road race, I didn't have to learn how to drive a car. I just had to learn the nuances of whatever I was driving. And I think a lot of people that have never raced or driven cars competitively don't quite get that when you get a certain amount of experience, you're not starting from square one anymore. You should be able to hop in the car and then be able to make good laps.
Right.
And then you're going to creep up on the nuances of the car and get faster and faster. And that's kind of how I equate my experience with sim racing is I should be able to jump in a car. And unless the car is broken, bad setup, whatever, I should be able to just jump in and drive. Because that's exactly what I did when I went road racing.
Right. You should just, it's always, if you can get to the point where you're looking for the last 10%, then you're already there.
Yeah. Nice. This is a, hi. Hi.
Car left. It is always weird to me getting into a game with no spotters. You get kind of, I feel like iRacing crutches you to spotters a bit.
Yeah, I legit didn't think you were up alongside of me. Right. I didn't think there was enough room. So yeah, this is cool. I mean, even the front wheel, this is a front wheel drive, correct?
Yep.
I'm like gonna talk on my ass.
but you can feel the back moving around.
Yeah, and like when you stomp on the throttle, you can feel it kind of do that little bit of light feeling in the front end.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't feel over-exaggerated. It feels like just enough to kind of, well, just like a real car would, give you the idea of what it's doing. So you can actually get stuck in the sand, says Jim. Nice. Yeah, rubbing is racing.
Oh man, you really lost some front fender there.
Did I? Yeah. Yeah, well, you know, it kind of turned me a bit.
If you do F10, it'll show you if you have suspension damage or not.
Well, I'm about to have suspension damage because I'm trying to do this while looking.
Nope. Yeah, it's always getting out of your way.
Suspension. How would I tell if I have suspension damage?
If anything's yellow.
Oh, okay. I don't see anything. Unless I'm not on the right screen.
It was just a little kiss.
Yeah, you know. A good little infield course here, too.
Yeah, the Rockingham UK course, it's got some good layouts, it's not one of the better flowing places. Like, a lot, there's a lot of those kind of fake turns, I call them, that drive me nuts.
Mm-hmm.
They're just there to, like, upset your entry into a turn. Feels like a very modern road course design. But it looks good. You can definitely tell the difference between, graphically, this track. Blackwood was redone, but if we go to one of the older sets, you get transported in era, but they are actively redoing all of them. All right, I think you've gotten enough. Let's do a little heads up.
Oh, okay. Oh, do we have to? Are we restarting or what?
You don't have to do nothing.
Oh, okay. I'm like, what do I do?
What do I do? Two lap race.
Okay. You're gonna like put me on blast here. Let's see.
I don't think so. I think that's because this is a layout that I basically never have done anything on the Rockingham track. Because it's a little bit beyond the era that I was big into this.
Rolando says, asks, are the speedometer instruments HUD car specific? I don't know
what that means.
I think he's asking if it changes, if the HUD changes per car. I think that's what the question is.
Yeah, there are different HUDs in different cars. Like there's a Formula One car in here that has all the different crazy buttons and things that you need to use for that.
OBD says the car was done. I think they demoed it at some gaming event.
Yeah, I mean, everything looked done. The track looked done forever ago. Start of a good race is always a burnout.
Of course. You're clear.
Really, wide turns here that end up getting narrower than you think.
Yeah.
So one of the things that I put in my gripes list was the netcode.
Oh, yeah?
It definitely feels a little archaic to me. Especially when there's car-to-car contact, they get all weird. I don't really know how netcode is built, so I don't know. I'm not smart enough
to make those are words that I don't understand.
Yeah. But I do wish that they could make it something that's a little bit more modern. Come on, get those curbs. You know you want them.
Mm-mm. No. I see what they did.
Locking up that inside rear?
Yeah, no big deal.
There we go. I figured out that silly turn now.
Oh, too deep. You too.
That's the joy of driving a front-wheel drive car.
Right?
Big lockup. I do love that you can see the other person's head move.
Yeah.
Oh. See, you said you couldn't do it. Said you were gonna get hosed.
That's purely because I was cautious. I started getting confident on the second lap and I started overdriving.
I think that's
pretty good.
I think that's a good representation of the sim, though. Like, it's that quick to pick up, but it doesn't feel fake.
Yeah, it doesn't do anything weird. It's not doing things that I don't expect it to do. Everything that was happening there, like when I overdrove the car that second lap because I really started trying to push it in those sweepers because I thought that's where you were deficient. Then you picked it up, and then I was like, oh, shit. So then I started trying to drive harder, and oh, whoops. My bad.
You're good. No, you're fine.
I jumped
out.
Oh,
you disconnected.
Yeah.
You can just reconnect. It's fine.
Okay. Let me go. Hold on. So people don't know. Join. Display list of hosts. I hit the wrong button.
I'm at the wrong track.
Yeah, I'm at the wrong track. We need your sound bite. There we go.
Set up the next thing while you're doing that.
Yep. I should be already back in. So yeah, that's... It just feels natural, even though, yeah, you can kind of look at the car models and the track and say it's archaic. It doesn't feel archaic, though, when you're driving the car.
Right.
Oh. Oh, what's this?
I gotta do a thing.
A thing?
Did I do it? Looks like it.
Jim just said, feed cone into a sausage curb. It's what F1 drivers do.
It is the way.
Let's see. Starfox says R Factor was always dependent on mod quality. This is very true.
Yeah.
And Bonka Cavo
selection of default stuff.
Ah. Bonka Cavo says you can get stuck in AMS 1-2 with some cards. Oh yes, that's right. To see if they have a NASCAR mod for the oval here. Oh, at Rockingham?
Oh, yeah, they do. There is NASCAR mods.
Oh, is there?
Anytime I think you try to stretch an engine like this to do something with NASCAR, NASCAR is one of those things that needs any kind of stock car racing or dirt track racing or stuff like that. You have to design an engine around it.
Yeah, I could see that. Just with my experience, limited experience, playing around with AI and helping iRacing and stuff, the way things have to work is fairly unique, especially when you get into all the rules of how the car is supposed to handle tire wear, those things.
All right, my next thing to show off. This is actually the reason for the season. This is... Lift for Speed 100% inspired me.
Okay.
My name is Cone Dodger on the internet. Autocross is like my favorite kind of motorsport because it's for poor people. And this is one of the only sims out there that I think actually models autocross. And they do it in a way that is close enough that I actually used it as a tool. And I would get the courses... Because this is when the era where we were actually like plotting them on paper.
Mm-hmm.
And like I was part of the crew that would help set up the courses. And I would put them in the game. And I legitimately think that I got better at autocross through practicing courses in this. So I know it's not the most popular, it's not a very glamorous thing to put in your sim, but I think it's really important and I think it's a good tool.
Well, if we're doing grassroots stuff. Oh, okay. Was I supposed to change my car?
Course that I hoped it was going to be. Hold on, let me. That'd be fine.
Yes. Yes, Cone does have to show me his specialty. This was his idea, and he's got a... I am not a... I don't think I've ever officially done any sort of
this is not a great showcase because I have no idea where this course goes, but it's fine. Oh, we're good. We got it. But that is kind of autocross too. Like you don't really get to know what track you're going to before you get there. And the only way that you learn is through walking the course.
Okay.
So that is part of the
I'm real lost.
I fear that I am also lost, but I think I'm in the right place.
Jim says, wait, is this the one I made?
It might be. No wonder it's so messed up.
Darren asks, can you add AI to the multiplayer races?
I do believe you can.
I have tried AI a couple times to see. They are almost Gran Turismo-esque sometimes.
Yeah, that's a good description.
Their awareness does not seem to be real great.
No. All right, well, I never got a finish, so I'm going to say I got lost somewhere.
You got it wrong.
Oh, that is a left. Hold on.
Boop. You can co-drive, can't you? That sounds like fun. Oh, well, if you want yourself to get sick. You know what? I never tried that thing in WRC that you could do co-driving. Wasn't it WRC? I think you could co-drive in WRC.
I thought that would be an interesting addition. Like, if it gave you, like, your own pace notes. But I don't think anybody's had the balls to try that.
Right. Court says the LFS AI accurately simulates most of the online players. True. True. Dr. Lomont says this kind of reminds me of Coffee Break from GT4. That's where they got it from. Jim says yes. WRC had a coder mode. I thought so.
I'm not real.
I'm not real. I always down for Sims trying something different. So, do I need to join? Oh, no, I don't. Race, join race? What's it asking me? I'm just sitting here.
Ah, here we go.
New course.
A real course this time. This is an actual course. This is a course that I ran back in the day in real life.
Oh. It said go.
Yeah, I was already loading it. Restart. So after you see me go, you can join after that, and it works just like you would think, where it gives people space on course.
Oh, really?
But you can watch me go for the first time if you'd like.
Sure. Nothing like being schooled on something I am not familiar with.
Like if you're like, hey, Cone, come do some sprint car racing with me.
Yes. Oh, it's so backwards. It's running a sprint car is so backwards than what you think it should be.
I did just the tiniest little bit of it when that stuff first came out for iRacing, and yeah, it was a world that I was not ready for.
And people just don't realize how hard you have to drive the car, but then also balance the car similarly. So usually, you know, to make the corner, you go slower, and typically with a sprint car, you actually need to drive it harder. You are not driving it hard enough to make the corner. There you did it. Okay. This is cool.
I can spectate and watch you go for it.
Oh, God, no. I don't know what I'm doing. How do I
join? I don't know if you chose the right car. I'm in the XRG, by the way.
Oh, the XRG?
Yeah, we went nice and basic.
Garage and car XRGT?
Just G.
G, XRG. But don't see an XRG.
Up top.
It says XR. Oh, I see what you're saying. It says XRGT, but then it says I got you. Yeah, I got you. Yeah. I'll get there someday. Oh, yeah. We got white with the gold wheels. Sure. Join. Oh, God. I don't know what I'm doing here.
You know how autocross works, right?
I do, but I don't really know what I'm looking for.
All right. Pointer cone is pointing to the side of the cone that you need to be on, basically. So to this one, you need to be the left side of that cone.
So I need to go this way.
Yep. Then back. Oh, he's gone. He's out of here.
This way? Where am I going?
Yeah.
Through here?
Yeah, well,
It no make no sense to me.
I got a better idea. We'll give you a guided tour.
Oh, here we go.
So I'll get off the line so you can join. There he is.
So how do you know you're supposed to turn around the cone like that?
It's all in the pointers.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It just said be on the left. It didn't say turn.
It's a little hard to teach new people to do it. And this is actually what I did for a couple seasons. I was an autocross instructor.
Oh, okay.
And teaching people how to read a course is, it's its own thing. And I do feel like learning in something like this is really beneficial because...
you don't wreck a car?
There the first time, it's just a sea of cones. Like, your brain doesn't comprehend what you're really looking at. So this can really cut down on the amount of time before you're comfortable with it. I've never autocrossed with somebody up my butt before. That's a...
Well, you know. The first time for everything.
Yeah.
So you remember I think it would be much more interesting if you did.
Insurance would not appreciate it.
Yeah, right.
Yep, that's what you're supposed to do.
I don't think I can do that on my own without following you. Dr. Lamont says, LFS AI is more on rails than GT, shockingly. Yeah, it's a bit brutal.
Yeah. All right. Which it was never really intended to be a thing.
Okay, I'm going to see if I can do this. I don't think I can. I don't know. I don't...
I tried to leave enough tire marks to give you the way.
Where's it at? This way? This way. This way.
Got it.
And then through here? That was probably not right. I need...
You're right. Yeah. Sorry, I'm watching on a delay on
stream. Right. I don't know.
Yeah, I haven't... You got it. You got it.
Okay.
Alright, he may have... Oh, no, you got it. Okay. Sorry, it's such a delay.
This way? I fucking don't know. Oh god, I don't know where I'm going. We'll go to over here. I think I hit a cone.
It'll give you the lovely thunk.
I'm pretty sure I didn't do that right. Oh, I did.
Get a time. Hey, you got a time at the end. You're good.
Hey.
All right, come on down. I'll hand you the keys to my car.
Oh, yeah. No, I would definitely need more learning with the cones. I mean, I guess riding along with somebody or watching, like you said, yeah, walking the course would be a great help.
That's generally how it works, where...
right first time.
Yep. I'll take a novice out with me for the first time so they can see the course from the car perspective, but you also walk the course in the morning.
Oh, I did hit a cone. I got a penalty.
Ah, hate to see it.
I did.
But yeah, I think I can't think of any other sims that handle low speed physics as well.
It felt pretty good.
To, like, drive low speed in iRacing?
Oh.
It's awful.
There's a lot of them that have a problem with low speed stuff. You know, I think part of the thing that I always complain about, it's gotten less over time, but, I hit two cones. Jim says I hit two cones. Well, they were in my way and they shouldn't be there. That's my opinion. OBD says Togue rules autocross. It would be in, do they have a Togue in this?
Togue?
Togue? Togue? Togue? Those... words that I do not understand.
That I have ever seen. But they do crazy stuff in New Zealand, where their autocross is basically like they close down a city square and they run it through just like the streets and factories and stuff like that. And that's what they consider autocross. And that's a lot more brazen than we are here.
Yeah. I always wanted to do a hill climb. There used to be a hill climb that was close to where I live, and then it no longer exists. But, yeah.
If I ever had infinite money and infinite balls, they do the Tail of the Dragon one here, but... I don't have either of those right now.
See, the problem is I'm stupid enough to do it, and I will probably crash.
Yeah. All right, how about we look at some mods?
Sure. So they added mods how long ago?
Like a year, I would say. A year ago. And the way it works is you submit it through basically their web interface, and they do a little bit of, you know, making sure that you're not just ripping out assets from other games, which I appreciate that they're making an effort to do that, because
yeah,
that is a plague. Looking at you, Assetto Corsa. Looking at you, R-Factor. Looking at you.
Somebody feels seen.
And they are pretty good about like making sure that there's no licensing errors, because that's where things can get ugly.
Sure.
And I think that's why they were afraid of doing this kind of stuff in the past. So it's super easy. You just go to the garage.
Go to the garage.
And you click mods.
Go to the, over here. And then, what'd you say, mods? Okay.
Yep. And up comes the whole list of mods.
Oh, look at all that. The BP50. Perfect. As it should. Oh, we've got, a pochette.
You can super... do, on the right, they did a staff's picks.
Okay.
Where they've got a few of that they thought were, like, great early examples of what you can do with all this.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
And you can see there's a pretty good...
speaking to my heart there, the McClary D8M.
I had a feeling. All right, let's try it. Let's see how sure we are with it.
Yeah, I'm down for being terrible. Harry McClary. Perfect. Federico says...
37 horsepower.
Yeah. No problem. Federico says, try the XRE by... Skawin,
who is one of the developers, main developer of the game.
Oh, okay, sure. Try that next. All right. Do I click OK? Yes.
Yeah. I'll put us in a race configuration, but you know it's going to be who dies first, really.
Right. Well, I mean,
on a track we haven't seen. This is an old track too. This is one of the oldest tracks.
So. I don't even know where I'm going, so I was born for this.
The difference between. The newer stuff and the older stuff. Oh,
two laps, wind speed at 7 miles an hour.
It's angry.
Yeah.
Full throttle, right?
Yeah. I don't know where I'm going, but I'm getting there fast.
Chicane.
Oh, there's a, yeah. I almost went full left. Woohoo! Oh! Little greedy with the throttle.
Jeez.
Hi.
Yep. You should brake a long time ago. You out here with me?
I'm getting there. I had to do a donut. Oh, are you stuck?
I'm getting there. I'm getting there.
Wait. Where are you at? There you are.
Definitely went for the good logical choice first. Oh.
Stuck.
We're going to get there.
Gear. Perfect.
Gear. Nope. Classic.
Okay. Josh just says, might be your best stream ever. Thanks for all the information. Oh, yeah. No, this was all Cone's idea. I love doing this kind of stuff, like having conversations, especially when I don't really know. Holy shit. Holy fuck balls. When I don't know the. Come back. When I don't know the topic.
I'm fine.
Yep. Okay, this is an easy second gear car. That's oh Jesus. He hit that bump and it just about launched me.
You need every eggshell under the pedal.
Right? Oh, this is great. I love it. Cause I'm an idiot. I like cars like this to drive.
Yeah, I used to. It was kind of my favorite thing to do with Assetto, but you try actual races with it, and it's just like...
Oh, it's a catastrophe.
Cool.
Right.
No, never.
And everybody, take it easy. And everybody's like, balls out first corner. Yeah. Neil, what did you miss the easy part? Oh, thanks, Ian. Star Fox says, this will be a fun time.
getting the hang of it now.
Yeah.
I haven't seen as much smoke.
Not yet.
I'm just here for the SR.
It's just not a first gear car.
No.
That's just what we've learned. And these bumps in the track are really, I love it. Yeah. It plays havoc with the car.
Uh-huh.
Oh, little much. Whoa. That was awesome.
The way it snaps is scary.
This is incredible. I love it.
Let's talk about that. Somebody talked about the sound earlier. So the way the sound engine works in this.
Mm-hmm.
There's no recorded sounds. So.
Oh, really?
They're not pulling samples to do this. It is. Yeah, it works like a synthesizer. They have the sound of explosions, and they are simulating what those explosions would do going through an exhaust system.
Whoa!
So what you are hearing is individual explosions. And I have to stretch my brain here. Yes, if you hit Shift A.
Shift A. Okay.
You can basically change the instrument, so you can change all of the variables of the exhaust system and how it's going to treat those individual explosion sounds.
That's awesome.
So, you know, it may be not the most authentic sound because, you know, a real recording is always going to sound more like the real thing. But it's actually simulated to what the engine is doing.
Yeah, everybody. ODB says, so if you use LFS tweaker and change a 4-cylinder to a 6-cylinder, the sound change. Nifty. Star Fox says, you can change them so many wasted hours. So many wasted hours messing with audio. That's really interesting. And that's a badass car. I really like it.
This is one of those things you can lose a day to. Just like, all right. I want to try and master this thing. Like, I want to try and tame it.
Yeah. You want to do it one more time?
Yeah, let's see that we've learned, right?
Right. Second gear, no first gear.
They need to move those brake markers back for this thing.
Woo!
Yee, nice!
Oh!
Oh, you got a hop.
Saved it!
We can go too wide, right?
Yeah, sure, why not? Oh, God! 360 no scope. Oh, I forgot about the bump.
I knocked my drink over. I knocked the floor
on
my desk.
Oh, no.
I probably just woke up a child.
Oh, shit. Oh. Oh, it was amazing.
I can't imagine why race cars aren't like this anymore.
Oh, oof, that was good. That was amazing. Oh, I'm crying.
Why am I in first?
Because you were in first before we did the shenanigans. I waited. I did. The funny best part was I did it, then you did it. I did a 360, stomped on the gas, and all of a sudden you just popped up right in front of me.
It actually handles the curves a lot better than you think.
Yeah, it's just you can't blast them.
Yeah. Yeah, let's just keep it off cam. You say blast him?
Yeah, that's it.
Kept it off the wall.
That's, nice.
I mean, that's something.
Good job. Oh. It's a climb, you know? I went in too deep. Oh,
you're in the air.
Yep. Sky. I think I broke it.
To get you a new one.
Yeah, I think I broke it. Oh.
Have you tried to look behind you? I don't know if you have that button mapped.
Oh, I don't think I do.
Oh, you're missing out on the best view.
Well, hold on.
It's good enough that you need to map it.
Okay. Rear view. We'll do this one. Okay. Oh, give me some stacks. Give me some big old stacks and a wang.
You don't need to see anything else but that.
Yeah, you know. Oh my gosh. That was hilarious. I think I broke my car though, because it don't move no more. Hey, you know, when you launch skywards.
Yeah.
Probably
done for.
I tell you what, that was hilarious though. That was fucking awesome. Star Fox says, I really hope the musician in Billy has an LFS V10 playing a guitar solo for one of his songs, like the Red Bull on Top Gear. Oh, yeah, there you go. Matt says, you can also change displacement, weight, tire width. 600 horsepower on a 145 tire is a riot. Can only imagine.
Oh, yeah, that was something that I messed around with a lot back in the day. It was before modding, you could always just change the physics of the cars.
Okay, somebody said try.
I'm looking for that one. Yeah, I was looking to figure out where it is. I wonder if I can do by author. Here we go.
Oh, that's the wrong. Oh, no, that's right.
Certainly don't how see, unless he didn't list it as that for the author.
I had to pick all, where it says show.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes
you
up.
Found it?
Yeah, Formula XR-E. I'm assuming that's what they're talking about. It's a Formula XR converted to electric power.
Oh,
we all know how much I love electric cars. I'm assuming that's it.
Assuming that's it?
Yep. Sure. Why not? I used to own an electric go-karting facility.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I only ever partook a couple times before my spine decided that was not the sport for me.
It was fun. It's a lot to deal with.
Yeah, I bet. Yeah, not only mechanical things to deal with, but ravenous humans.
Yeah. People think they're race car drivers and then, you know, destroy a cart. Yep.
Yep.
It can also be a 100-kilogram football. Yes, I saw that.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, we need to hit some of the goofy stuff at the end.
Okay, what is this?
Well,
South City Classic. Okay.
We'll try the XRE. This is probably one of my favorite tracks, especially in a formula car, so we'll see how it works with an electric.
Okay.
Oh, mine's not running.
Neither is mine.
Hmm.
How we make go?
I assume it's because it's electric.
Oh, it's you got to put it in gear.
In one, and I assume that's it.
Yes, and then I false started.
I need a restart.
That guy.
Yep, I'm that
need
guy.
To restart my ass. This is my server. I make rules.
Listen, bitch. I'm gonna do what I tell you to do.
Who set this up?
Okay.
Nope, still too early. What is it, 30 seconds, you think?
Sure. That says I have a 30-second time penalty. I'll just, you know, take some laps here. Figure it out. Oh, yeah, too late.
Yeah, you could turn on mirrors. I don't know. Why yours aren't, unless, are you on triples or something?
No.
No?
I have no idea. Is that in a graphic thing?
Maybe it's because the virtual mirror is on. Maybe you can have both. I don't know.
Good question. I don't know.
Could be because you have virtual on.
Okay. Well, pretend.
Yep. All right. Just don't jump this time, huh? Oh, I bet you the draft in this thing is nuts. Oh, it is.
Oh, I don't know what I'm doing.
Left turn.
Yeah, I don't know where I'm going.
There's an apex there somewhere.
Yep.
All right, this is a nutty chicane right here. So left, right.
Oh, this reminds me of Seattle Circuit.
Yeah. It's great. This is the shortest layout, so it's, you know, easiest to learn. Ooh, understeer there, huh?
Well, I didn't want to turn too sharp. You gotta keep up the rolling speed. Isn't that what you're supposed to do? Dear God, I have no idea what I'm doing.
Ooh, boy.
Woo woo.
Yeah.
Oh, turn, please.
If you make this turn, I don't know if I call that making it.
I mean, I didn't crash. That was me. I was trying to figure out how fast to go through there. That might have been a little too fast.
It's easy to recover in these. You can just keep your foot in it. Yow. Boy. Squeaked it out.
Whoa. Okay, one more time.
Yeah, we gotta do that again.
Now I didn't know where I was going. Was it in this?
The track.
Yeah, Lee says, was it in this game that Cone kept falling off of the bike? Oh.
Oh, yeah. Very much so.
Matt says, classic gamer muscle restart. Yes. We disconnected. Connected.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, latest. Finish the stream on your own, goddammit.
Start to end?
End to start? What?
What do I... Oh, I have to join. I see. XRE. I'm gonna go for a green one this time. I feel like the green one's gonna be the key.
Oh, we all know about green cars.
Yeah. How about three laps? I feel like we need another lap.
Okay, sure. The bikes are really hard to drive once you start out, says Magnet OS. It's
insane.
Oh, well, that might be what we have to end with.
Mm-hmm.
Cone's like, uh-huh. That doesn't sound like a good time to me.
Hit the button.
Button go vroom.
Apex there somewhere. A little squeak.
Squeaky.
It'll be all right.
Yep.
It's interesting being in a formula car that's this hefty.
It's a biggin. A small biggin? I don't know how that works.
Yeah. Thick.
Yeah, it's thick.
Multiple C's.
Oh, you're gonna get the draft.
Mm-hmm. Deceptively quick, too.
Yeah, like...
Whoa, right there.
Whoa, holy shit.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure if you're gonna poke your nose on the inside. I was leaving your room.
I did not think it would oversteer like that.
Oh, holy. Oh, Barrier.
I don't know how you held that.
It's my sprint car skills coming into play. That's about it.
Oh, no, electric sprint cars.
Oh, can't stop. Yeah. Stop it now. You make barf. That's surprisingly fun. Like,
yeah.
I feel like that.
One more lap.
Oh shit! I forgot for the... Oh, I pulled a Mark Martin and I'm wearing his shirt. Oh, I'm going to hit the fence. Yep. No worries. Yep.
God, the way it... Yeah, it just carries so much momentum in the turns. Kind of tricks your brain. Woo!
Holy Jesus criminy. I did Mark Martin proud.
Sure did. At least you can go to the pits.
This is true.
I just had to see if you could hold it wide. I think you could, but...
I did the second lap. I held it wide open, and... yeah. It feels... It's interesting driving this car, because typically when I've driven electric cars... In other sims, it feels like somebody telling you what they drive like instead of what they should drive like. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I get that. The drivetrain coast is a lot different than I feel like I've felt in anything else.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't feel like it... It has a ton of drag in it, so it doesn't... I guess
right.
It's not doing automatic regen braking, which is big.
Right, right.
And... I don't know, there just seems to be more compliance to the drivetrain. Which is interesting, because you know this was not developed for that shit.
Right, yeah. Matt says, if the tire model is fun, any vehicle is fun.
Any vehicle?
Any vehicle.
Well, let's see if we can find something that's yeah. Really stupid, then.
That's stupid is... This guy says, best sim. Ian says, this is the perfect level of competitiveness for me, which shows how much I actually care for serious wheel-to-wheel racing. Well, you know, you do what you like.
Yeah.
Let's see. Do I go to the pits? Pits, maybe?
Pits will take you to the...
Are we selecting something else? Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking for something that's... Not a bike, but delightful.
Oh, the
stupid.
Bug wagon. It's a work in progress, though.
I mean, it looks like it's progressed enough for me.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Fair enough. Starfox says you got a rallycross while you're here.
Yeah, I do suppose we haven't done a rallycross.
Okay.
In a bug wagon? Why not?
Sure. Ian says, I'm enjoying this casual chilling around stream. Yeah, like I said, I love doing this kind of stuff just because it's a chance for me to try out stuff that I wouldn't normally try out. Oh, again, the white with the gold? Yes, please. Blackwood Rallycross. Oh my gosh.
Of course, it does not have a setup, so you're going to have to click new setup.
Where would that be? In garage?
Yeah.
Okay, and then setup. New setup? Where's that?
New on top right? Under where?
Oh,
top,
I see. X, gonna give it to you.
I'm not gonna do anything but put, I guess, novelty tires on it? I don't know. Hybrid is kind of like the...
Tires.
Let's do hybrid, maybe. Yeah.
Hybrid? All right, fine. And that's it?
That's it.
All right.
Send it.
Do it. This can only be...
I hope it sounds like a bug.
Oh, look at the stinger out the back. Oh, I had a 71 Super Beetle. Yes, Conan...
Sounds a little too too spicy.
It's a little WRX-ish. Oh, but short burp. I have no idea what we're doing or where we're going, but this is gonna be amazing.
Right turn?
Oh, okay. Oh. I got what you're saying. Oh. This is what. Oh my gosh. Oh, who needs Wreckfest?
Yeah, I always wish they added more rallycross tracks. There's really only two.
Oh.
Who needs drive limiters? You got valves.
Right? Yep. Float those valves. When I was a kid, we raced quarter midgets. And it was all about floating the valves. If you're running hard enough, you float the valves at the very end, just before you start to dip, like as you dip into the corner again.
Mm.
Yeah. There's nothing that sounds like it.
Yeah.
The bread van. Hey, gluten.
Oh,
yes. Yes, yes. This is amazing. Ball.
Oh, wait. We're flying now.
I know. Sarwak says, wait, was a bug wagon like this a thing? I don't think so. I mean,
not officially, but you know people made them.
Oh, Cone's doing the Swedish. We're doing the flick.
The Swedish.
The Swedish Scandinavian. You know, look, it's all in the same vicinity. Don't just let's not, all right?
Oh, bog. Is this too much hill for you?
Right. It says, I slide and then I don't.
Open diff life.
Yep. The Viking flip.
Oh
no. You almost whipped it back into the guardrail.
I don't know, I might be a natural at this.
Yeah. Bread van Volkswagen crosses your game. And Jeff's like, now I want to play Live for Speed. Yes, if it has wheels, I'm in.
Lost all my momentum. Get out of here.
Move over.
Oh, this is fantastic to look behind as well. You love it when second gear is like at the limiter and third gear it's bogging.
Yep, it's perfect. It's the best ratio. Oh, gummer.
Hoping the grass would, like, open it up a bit.
Dr. Lomond says, imagine if you could port tracks to this game.
Oh, yeah. Major shame that they locked that down.
Oh, yeah, we're just slamming the car through here.
Oh, yeah.
Got some more speed up this hill.
I think you needed one more lap.
I needed an extra 5 horsepower is what I need. That's funny. You know what? For being a joke, it actually wasn't bad.
That was good.
Hi.
Hi.
It even has the little shades for the, I don't remember what you call those, for the headlights.
Oh, yeah.
That's funny.
All right, but how about one more before we bike? I need a
okay.
Little breather before we bike.
OBD says the other way around, but there is a port of Blackwood for Assetto. I think I've tried that. Goon says try BMNG, Billy. There's EV mod at 2,300. Yeah, I have BMNG. I've put way more time into BMNG than I have this, but probably not as much. As a lot of people, especially Cone.
Yeah. Beam is on my list for sure.
Yes, Beam is on his list to educate me on.
Racing? No, that one's lowly rated. Let's avoid the lowly rated. I want something that's like real old school, you know? Don't imagine there's a quarter midget, huh?
Right? Grand Prix Legend 65, Formula US 93, Snail Quadruple 1 Turbo.
Blimey Blower.
Pardon, excuse me.
Just type in Blimey.
They're calling me names. Oh, okay.
Yeah. We should probably change track for this, huh?
I mean...
Or maybe not.
I don't know.
With road tires?
Do you really think it's going to make that big of a difference? Cross-texture triangle found in something map... Oh, okay. Fixed itself, I guess. Race is starting. Oh. Do I hit okay?
Are you here?
There I am.
There you are.
Oh, I've just got a big old steering wheel in front of me. Fucking sweet. Oh, Lord.
Oh, that's it, huh?
Yep, that's all the revs you get. I can't see shit. I literally can't see it. That steering's so heavy. It's trying to rip the steering.
Like, is right for this.
Oh, my gosh. It's trying to rip the steering wheel out of my hand, and the steering wheel is so big on my screen. Oh, okay, good. Now I know what I'm in for. Great. All right.
I think this is more suited for this.
Oh, okay. Kyoto Ring. All right. I don't know. I think we were onto something there.
You think that was the future, huh?
Yeah. I mean,
good luck seeing the turns.
Don't. This is like driving a sprint car.
If I could only lean my head over.
Right? Oh, love the burnout. Yeah. Dude, I really can't see the turn. I'm literally trying to look. There we go. Don't need to see no stinking turn.
We have to run out of revs, right?
I'm assuming. Probably only has 4 gears, right? You think it has more than that?
I don't know. Yep, 4 is it.
Yep, 4. Sweet. This is going to get real rough here in a second.
I'm surprised it can hang in the turns. I guess we'll see down here.
Oh, the steering is so heavy.
Yeah. Here goes nothing.
I'm leaving your room. Oh, she's a little shaky up there. Got to keep my momentum up. Oh, where are you going? Oh, Jesus. Oh, you scared me and I hit the fence. Oh, there's a turn. I couldn't see it.
Oh, shit.
You flipped upside down. Dead. Oh. Oh. Oh, man. That was unbelievable. Camera options are good. No, this is great. I feel like I'm sitting in the car. Starfox says this is ridiculous and I love it. Yeah, you need a giant wheel. You got to hang off the thing. Oh, my goodness.
Right. It let me restart, so okay. We're doing it.
All right.
Oh, I've caught my breath.
Yes, we need the Moza truck wheel. That's a good-looking wheel.
Imagine the blisters you get.
Oh, yeah. Oh, floating it. I feel like I should have a very distinctive accent when I'm driving this.
Yeah.
Oh, we're floating it. Floating the valves.
I was worried there would be like nothing to it, but the turns are actually something.
Well, you get going so quick, and then, like, this turn, it starts hanging the back end out.
Yeah.
That's more interesting than I thought it was going to be. Oh, here we go. Look, I'm gonna have to side draft off of you here a little bit.
There's a turn here somewhere.
No, I can't even see it, so good luck.
I think it's here.
Oh.
Oh shit, that was close. Hey.
Whoa.
Hey.
Can you imagine a group doing this? Yeah, Brooklyn GP recreation. Jesus Christ. Oh, hi. Okay. We're turning now.
Oh, it's so nice to be following you.
Is it?
You have a marker of where the turn is.
Wait, do you have the steering wheel in your face like I do?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, awesome. Yeah, get GP laps on this ASAP. I think it'd be hilarious. I don't know where that wall is, but I think we got close.
More time around.
Yep.
Sponsored by Being Complete Idiots.
I resemble that remark. Oh, hi.
Draft.
Oh, now we're doing bump drafts. Oh, he's gonna slide it up the inside. You gonna make this? You gonna make that? Old lady sim, yes.
I put my wheel in between your two wheels.
Surely something amazing will happen at that point. Like, holy, just leave my foot in it. Don't lift, don't lift.
I don't know where the finish line is. I assume it's down here. He just loves to go upside down.
Oh. Yep, keep her lit. Oh, I just left my foot in it. We touched and the thing just slid the rest of the corner. It was amazing. Oh, that's great. Right, Star Fox says, I need a flat cap.
Yeah.
Okay. Are we going to endure the motorcycles?
I mean, I'm just gonna relish the fact that you're gonna be even worse at this, I have a feeling.
This is gonna be great.
We start with there are one in the staff picks now. Okay. Oh, there's a whole category for bikes. Here we go.
Yeah, the Camaro's in the staff picks. If you wanted to do that.
Oh, it sure is. Yeah, that one's got to be, you know, a good.
I like that. That one's got to be, you know, a thing.
It's got to be something Mark. That's been tested.
Okay.
You ready for this?
I have no idea. John says, hey, Billy, is this worth buying for the mods and the fun factor? Yeah, I don't know. If you hot lap, probably, or if you have a group of friends or find people to run with, buying it on its own, to me, is a little shaky.
It's a little pricey.
Yeah. What are you? You kind of look BMW-ish? White?
Have big
or maybe KTM? Maybe KTM? I don't know.
I don't know. I'm not really a bike guy.
It's a 998. So. Oh, we've got to do the annoying. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And just leave it as it is?
Yeah.
All right. What does that do? What does this do? Oh. Woo-hoo-hoo. Okay, not that bright.
You know what? We don't need three laps. I look at it.
We're gonna summon a wizard so that he can create LFS. So, oh my God, what the hell's happening? Dear Jesus!
It's gonna be, you know, down to get in first. You know that. You're a bike guy.
Yeah. Holy sh! Okay, how do I stand up?
Spacebar.
Okay. All right.
All right.
Oh, hey. What?
All right, I'm moving.
Okay. All right. Wait. This is gonna drive me nuts now. How do you counter?
You have to not.
What in the fuck?
You have to believe. All right, I'm gonna give you the pro strat. Third person view. Oh, he's got it. Oh, dang, he's done left me now.
Yeah, but I can't keep it straight on the straightaway. Oh, I lifted too much. Oh, I dead. This is why they don't race these things on ovals like this except Daytona.
I'm gonna make it.
All right.
I'm okay. I'm all right.
Okay. Physics. It's a little disconcerting to figure out. Oh, you gotta wait till you're done crashing. Okay. Okay, you can't start that way, because that's not gonna happen.
Oh, it will 100% pull the front wheel.
Oh, what do you mean pull the front wheel? Like do a wheelie?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I've been doing wheelies the whole time.
Yeah, I just flipped straight to my head.
Yeah, if I freaking dump it. Yeah, like. Okay, wow. If you're not faced the right way on the track, you are screwed. Oh my gosh.
Oh.
Well, you know, this is a something.
Yeah, it took me a good bit to get to the point where I could actually make laps. You really gotta shut a lot of your brain down.
Believe it or not, I have flipped a bike over that way. Okay, Jesus. I got it, and now I lost it. I don't understand what the impetus for the bike wobbling, though.
Yeah.
That is a very bizarre... I've ridden plenty of motorcycles. They do not do this. They don't just, like, wiggle back and forth like that.
And if they did, I don't think anybody would.
Right? This is a novelty, at the very least. I don't quite understand why you would want. Yeah, I don't. I've never ever had this problem with a motorcycle in my life. So. Oh, okay. And it. Yeah, this was your first lap on this track. Somebody asked if I have tried GP bikes. I have not. John asked, my issue with this stuff is bike games. I feel people have much too critical of a lens for, you are never, ever going to be close enough to figure out what a bike feels like.
Yeah.
In a simulator. It's just not going to happen.
You're already missing so much in sim racing, like cars.
Yeah.
You're missing so much of the picture with bikes that it's just, it has to be arcade or it's never going
to
work.
Yeah, there has to be a certain level of assist that happens just because you don't, there's so many, I've done track days on motorcycles and just the way you can drag the brake, the way that you lean versus the bike and just grabbing throttle and like counter steering, but you're not really like, it's just so many things are happening and the gyroscopic effect of what's happening in the engine and how that relates to how, what the bike is doing. Like there's so many things. Having played some of the other bike games that say they are simulators or try to be, I don't find them enjoyable because it relates nothing to a motorcycle to me. GB bikes and MX bikes do a really good job. You'd be pleasantly surprised. That's the one that has zero AI though, right? Like there's zero things for me to do in that. And I just have no desire to spend my money on something that I'm never going to play.
All right. Look for H-Bike V-Twin.
Oh no. Okay. H-Bike V-Twin.
I think this is gonna fix all the problems.
All the problems?
Yep.
H and then space bike?
No, just H-Bike, all one word.
H-Bike.
Definitely not a Hartley.
No, that doesn't come up.
Nothing under H-Bike, huh?
H.
Oh, you're under staff pick still.
Oh, mother trucker. Duh. Try it again. Oh, yeah. We get to do the drag light or the V2. Which one are you doing?
Let's do the drag.
All right. Terry, what's going on? All right. Hold on here. You got right here. Colors. Oh, you. New colors. Oh, no. Never mind. Don't want to do that. Drag biking it. Okay. My dad used to race drag race motorcycles as well. Okay. Well, that's a little flat on the twin sound there. Billy, wrong way shifting. Okay, we gotta do this again because I'm stupid.
Ooh, that's spicy.
Definitely.
Oh, come on. Oh, not enough.
I was just waiting to slide into you.
We gotta end it.
Your vote got canceled.
What if I go to pits? Can we end now? Hey.
Panda says, if someone ever figures out simulating all the physics involved in bike racing, though, they'll have a perfected model for most other racing, too. I mean, sure, there's so many systems that go into trying to simulate what a bike does. Okay. At least try the free versions before you dismiss them. Sure. Oh, I did it again. Oh, I mean, the good thing about me forgetting how to shift was I watched you wreck. Now we're watching you wreck more.
Well, let me restart.
Oh, the bikes.
We can do this.
All right.
We can do this.
I got to remember,
supper, but
one down.
We've got to get this.
Okay. One down, five up. Yes.
I hear grinding.
Yes.
Oh, I'm leaning. Okay.
I'm so good at this.
I'm going to take it. You're on your side.
Yeah. Look, I got to look at the Christmas tree, and that's pretty good looking. It's a nice... Nice thing. Thing that they do.
Got this. I believe in you.
Okay. So what are you taking it up to launch?
It sounds like half. I'm like quarter throttle. Eighth throttle.
Oh, wow. Hey, you went over the line. Disqualified.
Yeah, disqualified. Hey, you made it though.
I did. Where's my chute?
Yeah.
Oh. This is just how bike drag races end. Everybody just falls on their side.
There has not been a like sim drag racing game in a long time.
Yeah, you know what? I don't know if I have a few, and I remember trying to play one way back in the day.
Oh, you got it. You got it.
I made it. And now we're gonna die. Speed wobble.
Donk. Oh, head first.
Oh, I did it. Oh, I did it.
One and you won at life.
Woohoo. Yeah, I won everything. Did it. Amazing. Starfox says, it's a shame Pobosa doesn't cut the price of those games, but then he doesn't make yearly throwaways. Yeah, I just don't find them very compelling. I mean, if I was into doing track days for the kart one or either one of the GP ones, there was also, maybe it wasn't him, there was also somebody else that had made a sprint car dirt track one that, that was similar, but there's just no meat on the bone.
Bye.
Oh, sneaky fucker.
Had to be done. Simply.
Oh, nice.
All right, well, I think I've got to get out of here to supper up.
Yep, nope, that was great. Thanks for hanging out, everybody. That was a lot of fun. Thanks to Cone for suggesting this and then let alone doing it, which was great. We have to do this more often.
For sure.
At least I had fun. Yeah, so Cone is on Twitch. Cone Dodger, is it just Cone Dodger or is it 240 on Twitch?
It is Cone Dodger 240, both places.
Yep, on Twitch and on YouTube. Your YouTube, you have two different YouTubes. You have the automotive stuff is the main channel.
If you go to Cone Dodger 240, it's going to be mostly automotive content, unless you go back into the old stuff when there's a bunch of gaming content.
And then you have another channel for the gaming stuff. So,
yes.
Yeah. There, though. So that was fun. I feel like I got a little hosed on the last race there, but that's all right.
Eh, you know.
Yes, thanks everybody for hanging out. Again, appreciate Cone. That was a lot of fun. So,
my pleasure. Love to show off a game that I feel like deserves more attention.
I agree. And so real quick, let's give a quick synopsis. What can modern sims learn from Live for Speed?
More data, right? Like more intuitive things to tell you what's going on with the car helps.
I would agree with that.
I didn't really get into the visuals too much, but a little bit of that too. I guess it kind of goes hand in hand, right? Just keeping it very tight. Keep it something that gives your brain the easiest chances possible to understand what's going on with the car.
I think that, you know, from somebody that doesn't have any nostalgia for this title whatsoever, coming from me, I really liked that whole setup. Their visual, I'll call it a visual explanation of what the car's doing, what changes to the car it does, and kind of giving you, if you're into trying to set up a car, this is probably, I can't think of anything else off the top of my head that's any better than showing those things right there. the amount of minus the bikes, the amount of intuitive driving that happens with pretty much everything that we tried, especially with the official stuff, was really good. I'm not a super big graphics person. Yes, I don't want it to look like dog shit, but I think this looks fine. It does look dated. I think for me, the biggest downfall is kind of what I was complaining about with the Pobosa stuff. It feels like unless you don't have a group to run with or find a group of people that enjoy Live for Speed, you're kind of buying a hot lap simulator. And for me, I have no desire in doing that. So for me, that's the shortcoming, is that there's no, again, there's no real meat on the bone in that regard. But as...
Say the same of Assetto Corsa. I feel like Assetto Corsa was always that way too. Some AI, but I'd always felt very hollow.
I made the AI work, so I would say I had way more fun with that. But I would say that the driving is probably better in this, even though Assetto Corsa got better over time, and depending on the mod that you pick now and all that. I really didn't like Assetto Corsa when it first came out. I thought it was, things were really broken with that. It did get better. Cars, official cars were still broken. Yeah. For me, AC, I don't play AC anymore, but AC still has more meat on the bone to it, but that's because I can go in and mess with it. Right. If we're taking it from a vanilla experience, that's tough. AI is probably more functional than this. But as a driving simulator, as a get in, make laps, it feels great. So I mean, driving with other people always usually makes it better. Like you have more fun with friends anyway. So trying to take that out of the equation. There are things that still hold up. My main impressive points would be the setup deal. That's pretty cool, and I'm surprised that nobody else really shows something like that. So yeah.
I guess that's I'm curious to see if you'll be inspired to pick it up, you know, just here or there.
And, I would say probably not. Unless I get, you know, unless in a group or something, then I would totally do it. But on my own, no. There's just not enough for me here. But if somebody, you know, did a server or something and they're like, Billy, you want to run? I'd be like, sure. I mean, it's, the cars are great to drive. Like,
yeah,
they're a blast. So, and I don't have an issue with the graphics. Like I said, they're dated, but it's fine. Yeah.
Well, once we get enough people together to run those GP cars on an oval with 20 people, I'll let you know.
Yeah, extend the gear ratio just a hair.
Just a bit. Just a touch.
All right, everybody. Thanks for hanging out. Again, appreciate it. That's your look at Live for Speed retrospective and then kind of my thoughts at the end. Thanks so much for hanging out. We will see you later again. ConeDodger240. Go check out his channels on both Twitch and YouTube. And I will see you all later. Take care.